Just causing myself problems with my keyboard. All right, there we go. Welcome, guys. It's game number two of Call to Arms series, and it's a match between MBL, the current champion, against Degal. The score currently is 1-0 in Degal's favor, actually, after winning the first map. So that's going to be pretty exciting for this, serving up game number two. It's the home map of MBL, and he's chosen Double Arena, of course. And by meaning of Double Arena, for those who don't know, and of course on YouTube and whatever, it is double. Everything is double. The gold is double, the stone is double in terms of actual amounts. So it's kind of crazy. Double berries, double boars, double deer, I think, as well. So, yeah. Yeah, double deer as well. This is crazy. Basically, a really fast start in general. Which basically means you can get pretty nice in castle times and in imperial times and so on and so forth. So, civs-wise, we got in the blue here, Degal playing as the Chinese. And in the red, of course, we're gonna have MBL, the current champion of the series so far, as playing the Turks. Now, I was talking a little bit before the start actually of the game, that I was kind of assuming a little bit here that MBL will probably go for a fast Imperial option. He could go for a fast castle. It's definitely not off the cards. But I don't know. It's one of those crazy things I've got in my head where I'm like, if he does a fast Imperial, this could actually work really well. Who knows? Having a look at the maps though so far, MBL's got most of his gold actually in terms of main gold piles and a secondary gold pile to the left-hand side of his TCs actually. And with this actually stone wall being like it is, if they like one stone wall like here or a house or whatever, this entire back area is actually really secure. Or front area, sorry. And it's actually pretty well secure resources too as well. Rest of the map wise as well, he's got another back stone to go to and those extra sheep as well. Oh yeah, also he's got extra sheep as well. That's just crazy. So crazy food, crazy resources. Therefore, it could be a crazy game. I really hope it doesn't turn out to be one of the dullest games of the series. Because I'll be like, oh, the hypers are real, and yet it fell really flat. Unless I bring that second boar in right now. Having a look about Degal though, what's he up to? Oh, he's just gathering all those resources wise. Let's have a quick look at the relics. I don't think relics are actually that important in this series. I know it's because as a reader, like, oh, of course, relics will always be important. And they are important in AOC in general and in Arena. But when you were playing double Arena and you've got double the amount of resources in terms of gold and everything, I don't think like that hunt for relics is going to be like the number one priority like it normally is. Whilst the game is rolling, let's have a look. Also, yeah, you start with double scouts too. It's just like more and more additions have got to keep adding to it, like more comments. So yeah, I'm curious as to how they're gonna be managing their economy and everything because, of course, it's a completely different scenario in terms of you've got two TCs and like those extra resources. I feel like you'll get this balance quite right. I mean, like, you must think, oh, it's impossible, you've got double the resources, but you just saw there, like, tons of bills and food and everything, and it doesn't make the transition very well, or smooth, or cleanly. It could cause a few issues. Like this here, it's a little bit scrappy, I don't particularly like. You could have transitioned some bills from, like, the sheep onto this. Boars here, like a little bit of waste of food. I feel it's got one's on like 150, the other one's on 175. Like, and it's not like they can't even lane the boars anyway. So to me, it feels like a little bit of a waste, but of food, like a little bit. But it's fine. I'm just being really nitpicky as well, to be honest. So don't mind me. Let's see what's going on here. So Degal's going to the gold already. It looks like this raid starts picking up right now. Degal looks like he's certainly ready to do that. BL probably isn't too far away. They go to Gao as the first one to click up right now. And actually 30, 41 pop, 39 bills. Actually two ahead actually of MBL. Of course, did have China start though. So he gets a couple of extra bills. And because of the fact they got so many resources to begin with and actually being so close, that actual time difference of not getting the TCs to be at so idle, it's actually quite important to note. Looks to me that actually looks like Degal as well is looking to do maybe monks here or something. Maybe, who knows? It's got plenty on gold. That's what's all Chinese monks though, and they're all right. They're pretty good. We'll probably do some siege monk strat most likely. Looking at this build so far. Who knows? But he's definitely got plenty of gold down there as well. Or he could just do crossbows, either one. Let's see if he puts the barracks down, though. I don't see any barracks yet, though, so it looks like to me it's going to be Monk Siege. Whilst for MBL, looks like he's got build down on gold, 5 on gold, it looks like. And he has picked up as well. Well, is that the same pot? But look at the time difference, 30 seconds difference. And yet, build count's actually one ahead, sorry, for Tegal, so that's crazy. Why do I suck? Oh, it's just Super Boa. Super Boa just upset over losing to a certain player that we will not discuss because he's too ashamed. Anyway, though, Feudal Age is coming in right now for both players, Tegal and MBL, respectively. Looks like it's actually going to be a blacksmith and actually a barracks there, so I was wrong. Looks like it's actually going to be probably more towards that archer range. Or even maybe a stable. Where is that though? Okay, oh, so I was really curious. I was like, I see the blacksmith being put down, but not the extra building. It's actually a stable. Wow, I was really wrong. I thought it was actually going to be in an archery range. But it's actually going to go with a stable option. Ah, so it doesn't mean I can rule out monks just yet. It could be doing a couple of scouts to try and have some of the map control. Could be that. Meanwhile though, MBL just buying a bit of wood actually. That is new. He's actually kind of... Has he actually screwed up a little bit here? Or is this part of his bigger plan? I really think it could be an FI. But he's got two mining camps and a lot of gold being mined, actually. And there we go. Now he's picked up buying a bit of food. I don't know, he's got nowhere near enough amount of food income to do an FI. For sure, right? I don't know. I give up predicting. Couple of sheep here actually being put apart here. There comes a scout fights right now actually. He's actually coming up on top here. Looks like to me it's actually going to be Tegal here. Yep, Tegal is definitely the winner of this fight. MBL should probably want to back out. But looks like Tegal is going to be the winner of that fight. He's got one scout remaining and he's actually got two stables actually been popped down actually. This is interesting. Not something I would have expected here. I really, of all things, I was like, oh, Monk Siege, okay, and then it came to like, crossbows, like, oh, wait, now it's two stables, so I'll be honest, I really wasn't expecting that. Oh, so looks like the cast stages are now, it's about to come in. Just about now, actually. 14 minutes 3 is the first one to be called Tegal, actually. I'm just really curious for MBL here. Because, I mean, look at the resources currently. He's going to enter cars like just like 500 food and 800 gold. I'm just praying for a fast Imperial play from him. Please, just offer me that. That's all I want. Just so I can at least get one thing right. Tegal here, though, is finally in the car slave. Got knights actually been pumped out here from those two stables, actually. That's really bold. Now I'm really curious as to his next strategy. What's he going to do? TCs? Yeah, you got another TC being popped down, actually. Yeah, it's the third TC. And I wonder if the next TC being popped down somewhere nearby, I wonder. There you go, actually, there's a monastery instead. He's going to get those monks out, start picking up some of the relics. MBL buying some food. It's got us. Oh, he's doing it. He's doing it. He's doing it. Yes. Good lad. He's doing for that fast Imperial. 18 minute uptime is going to be. Oh, that's disgusting. I love it. Barracks now coming down, of course. Going to get the Archer Rangers to do hand cannoneers and all that business. Oh, I love it. I'm getting really excited just because of the fact that, one, I got something right, and two, it's Turk doing a fast Imperial. But the beauty about it as well, of this fast Imperial build, is that it could be really deadly. On the fact that normally when you're doing fast Imperials, your build count's like, what, early 30s in numbers? But because of Double Arena, he's close to 60. 60 bills going and doing a fast Imperial style build. He's gonna actually have a lot more resource than normally expected. And because of that, this could be really dangerous for Tegal. Tegal, though, meanwhile, though, he's actually getting bloodlines and scale barding arm. He's got a house in the middle of the map as well. It's curious. It's Also getting a couple of more monks also on the field too. Furthermore, well, the Gal still already only has 3 TC. He's just doing an average 3 TC boom here. This is pretty ballsy. But the thing is, though, as well, at the same time, is the fact that, yeah, we're doing a 3 TC boom and all that. But he won't be actually too terribly far from picking up either. He's actually spent a lot of his resources actually in getting the chain barding armor. So actually, he actually had a pretty good resource, but he just spent it all. So there goes that theory. He's just going to get chain barding armor nonetheless. 3 archer range is being popped down right now, and MBL is about to hit that all-important Imperial upgrade just any second now. Siege Barge has been popped down right now. A couple more monks also actually coming up from MBL. 3 rangers, hand cannon is popping out. MBL also getting the hand cut. The Gals are just patrolling the map with the knights that he currently has with plus 2 armor. No attack upgrades just yet. Looks like actually the Gals going to fetch that last relic, it seems, that he can get, because one is actually at the back of MBL's base. That's just pretty disgusting. Now, an outpost being popped up by Dagao as well. Just want to get a little bit of map vision. Want to see what's going on and see where maybe MBL is going to be. And actually, it's going to spot out MBL just a second, actually. Oh, that's a few locked there. And there we go. The hand cannon is getting to work already. Going to start targeting down the outpost. I mean, why not? But really, I think MBL should really start, you know, turning up the pressure a little bit more. But it's going to take away his outpost. So he wants to get rid of that vision so that, you know, Dagal's playing in the dark, it seems. 3 monks out as well, as I mentioned just now earlier. Now it goes down that third stable, actually. Forging being done as well. And because these massive knights, look at that, 50 to 40 in the military front. There's a little bit more, but because of monks in action right now, a couple of hand cannons getting stuck involved too. A couple of conversions do fly out. 3, in fact, if we all get their conversions off. That's really huge here. Now the hand cannons getting stuck to work as well. The bombard cannons are actually staying alive here. Aren't getting focused down. Whilst the knights actually are. This is actually a pretty good fight here, I think, here for MBL. It's actually cleaning up most of those knights. Oh, that last bombard cannon shot as well, doing some good work. One bombard cannon does go down a few monks, but in terms of trade-off and actual efficiency, that was a really good fight for MBL. Now he can put the pressure down. But Dagal, though, so we're getting a castle up, it seems. Actually going to try and put that extra gold there as well. But I don't think that MBL's going to care. Actually, he's going to focus it down. Now she's got 2 bombard cannons, but got to be careful, those knights. They're going to go for a wrap around and take care of those bombard cannons. A couple of shots are flying up. Plenty of knights being pumped out right now. Now the husbandry being done too. Once we close down those units even quicker, the castle will go up. Now, it looks like MBL to be forced to go back here, it seems. But he is actually cleaning up, to be fair, a lot of knights. Now, a couple of another archer range being popped forward, too. And the bombard cannon also been done. Now, also a forward siege workshop as well. Dagao has lost a lot of units. And look at the population right now, 110 to 90, actually. And what is the current resources of Dagao? He's so far from clicking up. This is actually quite dangerous, actually, to be fair. Now he's actually dropping down 3, 4 archer rages, crossbow, bodkin arrow being done too. He's just going to go for a full castle age play here to try and beat off this fast imperial push. Monk, now another monk coming onto the field. Does need a few more hand cannons. I think he might need the extra armor upgrade too. That'll be quite nice. Take care of that deer. $107 bills out of 79, that's actually been pretty disgusting. Looks like going to be that, well, pretty obvious actually, that MBL's changing tact. He doesn't really want to fight that castle. It's pretty, at this point, it doesn't really mean that much to him because no one's really taking gold there or not that late into the game just yet. So instead, he goes straight for where it hurts in that economy, of course, and now breaks down that stone gate. Got 4 bombard cannons moving on in. Really wants to go try and keep him alive, though. I'm hearing a monk trying to convert a knight, of course. Crossbow trying to get involved, but I don't think the crossbows are actually going to really add much in general. The hand cannon is just so much stronger. yes, a little bit less accurate, but one, the guy hasn't got ballistics, and two, they don't have much HP and the damage and everything, so I think the crossbow choice is a bit flawed. He needs to get like covering and ballistics and micro like a boss to even basically think about it, really. Now the cast coming up with the gallows trying to come out of base, and here comes a big fight though right now, and punching up all those hand cannoneers though. Kind of kite it as he goes backwards, but didn't actually pay out that well, really. There we go. Now being pushed into a corner, it seems. Bombed by cannons. Probably should start focusing on those crossbows, actually. Be a good idea. Now he is, but the knight's also taking care of business, too. The hand cannons are actually dying here. Now with the plus two attack damage being researched, and just a pure blood coming out right now for the gal, he's actually taking this fight extremely well. God, that was a little bit unexpected. I didn't think that would go so well, but... just those damn knights, man. I mean, are we surprised? Maybe that NBL should probably do some camels, but that's what the crossbows are there for, really, to try and stop that from happening. Now the hand cannon's got to try and walk back to the base and try and just snipe what he can. Now the guard's clicking up, and this is where it's actually now... this timing window of it. MBLs is now falling short. Two petards have come out from the gal too. I'm gonna try and actually break inside the base of MBLs. Probably try and end the game from there. Big nice bomb by cannon shot. That just takes another four of those crossbows. I'm surprised those P-tiles have sort of been hanging about a little bit. I think he's just trying to wait for a good amount of army that he's massed up to then break on through. Most probably. One, two castles. Has he got a third at all? I think he has, actually. Okay. Okay, there's that third one actually being nice and put aggressively just on the outside of MBL's base. I'm going to cover a little bit of that gold, of course, and that relic too. Now here come out those hand cannoneers once more. 42 military to 25 though. That is just terrifying. Thumbring now being done. No, oh, did I just get deleted? Oh my god, I got taken out. Wow. That actually might have saved MBL there. Like, just as he was building it, like, MBL's bombard cannon just shot it down immediately. That's a disaster for the gal, really, losing all that stone. But it's double arena, so someone is likely short on stone in terms of resource gathering. So, another one shortly, that's for sure. Arbalest being done, cavalier option also being done at the same time, too. Now, here come a lot of hand cannoneers this time. 53, 36. Lots and lots of those crossbows now going to Arbalest, of course. Plate binding armor being done. Cavalier conscription also being made. Batting round actually done by Degal. Ooh, that was really bad. Because now, it's allowing now NBL to start pushing out a little bit more. And this actually stayed up, these two buildings. I'm really surprised by that. But you can't ignore this sheer mass. There's just not enough army here from MBL to take care of it, because once that cavalier option's been done, and of course, the bracer really put together. Degal really needs to get the bracer actually for those arbalest. He's actually gonna get ballistics. I hope he hasn't forgot about it. But on the retreat, he has to be, because he just realized what is coming along his way. Just a ton of cavalier and arbalest. He has got a fair amount of hand cannons, but still not be enough. He's also got a lot of bombard cannons, and that's a precious amount of resources. They're so expensive, he can't lose them like this. Now he's coming towards an engagement here. He's going to try and pick his fight. Castle has come up in the nick of time as well, by the way. And here come those bombard cannon shots too. He's trying to focus down this arbalest as well. Hand cannon is forming a line of defense too. Hat round's going to bring the castle down. Not going to work out too well. Bunching up into this small mass here for those hand cannons. He's doing a great job, actually. Get those bombard cannons firing. There we go. Going down, they are. But so did all of those hand cannoneers, though. first the Cavaliers went down too, but still plenty for Cavaliers to try and take care of these Bombay cannons. But so did all those Catmans went down at the same time. Down go those Bombay cannons. And the push is continuing too. The Trebuchet is actually getting really up close and personal to the castle. I think that might be a rallying point issue. Though he's just going to unpack it right next to the castle. This could be. This could be game, I think. I just don't know what MBL's got in the bank. He's got 6 military and 37 towards the Gowan. The Gowan's resources look extremely strong. MBL's got no food in the bank left. He's got a bit of gold. He can probably try and buy some food, but that's not going to work out too well. Now he's going to go for Bombard Towers here, but Seadram already been upgraded. Trebuchet also out, and now here comes the Cavalier as well. He's going to get stuck in. And there we go, GGB pulled by MBL. Dugao is taking it 2-0 so far. So he is actually now the confirmed winner of this series. But we have got a game 3 to go to, because of course all 3 games are played. But wow. I loved MBL's idea to do this fast Imperial strat. It's nice and aggressive play. I love it, that sort of thing. But unfortunately, I just... I think the execution of it just wasn't quite there. It was close enough, but Dugao again did a really solid defense. He decided just to go full knights and then with the crossbows. I was actually really critical of the crossbows. I was a bit like, well, what's the kind of point of it all? Especially didn't have ballistics at the time or even Thumbring. And I still not a big idea for it. But because of the way the engagement played out and the fact that the Bombard cannons weren't really targeting the crossbows, it then kind of just paid off because the hand cannon has kind of got swamped as well. And yeah, that's where we go from there, to be honest. I think MBL, yeah, he could have won that game if it just that execution of it was just a little bit off cue. That was all, I think. But there we go. GG, well played though. Dugao, monster. Look at that. 8,000 more food, 5,000 more wood, 1,500 more stone, and much a bit more gold collected for MBL in the end. There you go, and even collecting 2 relics, but who cares about the relics, bruh?